Hey folks, Ariel over here at Fineth. Today I just wanted to do a quick video about weather forecasting. I've gotten various questions over the years about weather here. It's obviously cold and snowy. The snow's been piling up and then melting down and piling up again. Burley's actually laying down in the biggest snow pile that's still left in the shadiest spot behind the camera. Anyway, people will ask me, what do I find the most reliable weather forecast here in the mountains? None of them. That has been my experience. I know weather forecasting is difficult in the mountains, but generally if I want to know what the forecast is going to be, I look at about three or four forecasts. If they all are saying the same thing and we're only a day or two out from whatever that time is, I will assume there's a fairly high probability of that thing happening. Sometimes a day or two out, they are all saying very different things, and then I figure it's a toss-up. People also ask me, how much snow am I expecting to get this winter? I think the most reliable way to know how much snow you're going to get in the winter is wait until spring, and then you will know. But regardless of that, just thought it would be fun to share a little bit about some, I guess, folk weather predictions. I know the Old Farmer's Almanac is forecasting for my general area here, you know, a much bigger stretch than just my area, but forecasting that we're supposed to have cold temps and deep powder this winter. One of the things that I learned from some folks who have lived in this area for a very long time is that, one, I know people in different areas will look at those little woolly bugger caterpillars or things like that. Maybe there's some here, I never see them. If there's any, there are very few. One thing that does seem to be somewhat reliable here in the years I have been watching, and I've heard this from folks much older than me, is that most people call them bees' nests. They're not technically bee nests, they're technically paper wasp nests, or a hornet nest, whatever, those like gray balls like this where the bees come and go from the bottom. The location of those seems to somewhat predict the snow depth for the year. So for instance, one year, as the leaves started to come off the bushes and stuff and you could see the nests hanging, they were almost all like clear down on the ground. That winter, we had very, very little snow. Cold temps, but even in like January, February, in the bottom of the valley, there was brown showing, highly unusual. Another year that I have lived here, as the leaves came off the trees, you could see those nests, and they were all like 60 feet or more in the air, up in treetops. There was nothing down low. That winter, we broke every record for this area, I think for the state of Wyoming, for snowfall, since record keeping had started. So it's not a direct correlation. 60 feet in the air doesn't mean 60 feet of snow, but way high in the air seems to generally correlate with a lot of snow. Way low seems to correlate with a low snowfall. I have no idea how the critters do this. I don't think anybody else does either. It would probably be fascinating to know what they're picking up on that seems to correlate. But we're just throwing out there right now, the Old Farmer's Almanac is saying that we're supposed to have a cold, low temp and deep powder year. My guess, because all the nests I have seen this year have been somewhere between here and here, right in this level. They're not on the ground, but they're not 60 feet in the air either. So my guess is that overall we're going to end up with a below average snowfall for the year. We'll see in the spring, get to about the end of June when it quits snowing or whenever that is, and we'll see who was right. And of course it doesn't matter. I love when it actually snows more. I kind of hope I'm wrong because I like deep snow and deep powder, and I just really enjoy that. But that's my guess. So I just thought I'd throw that out there, and I would love to know what are you guys' favorite kind of folk forecasting things in your area. I know everyone's got different stuff in their area. That one seems to hold pretty true here. I don't know about across the whole Mountain West, but here in this specific area, that's my guess based on what those bugs have been doing with their nests this year. Again, we'll see in the spring when I'm right, but tell me down below what are the forecast tools like that you guys have noticed seem to be somewhat reliable. And I hope we all enjoy whatever kind of winter we have, wherever it is. You guys have a lovely day. Hi folks, Ariel over here. Thanks for spending some of your valuable time watching these videos. Hopefully you found something beautiful, educational, interesting, peaceful, relaxing, or useful while you are here. If so, find more videos here, subscribe so you don't miss any updates, and if you like what you found here, feel free to like and share away so that others can benefit as well. You all have a wonderful day.